this particular segment of the population. The United States does not collect census data on sexual orientation and gender identity, and this means that we don't have accurate or consistent information about the particular needs and experiences of this population. I would argue that our lack of knowledge leads to disparities and inequalities among LGBT elders. And so I guess overall, this reality highlights the importance of research that not only makes a scholarly contribution to our understanding of LGBT aging, but can point to innovative policy and practice solutions to improve the lives of LGBT elders. So the reason why I decided to get my PhD, throughout my first year, I've been asking myself this question a lot, why am I doing this? Honestly, I've been driven by a desire to create a better world and to improve the lives of disadvantaged people. I have the deepest respect and gratitude for the LGBT folks who came before me, who paved the way for me to be here today, to sit on this panel and to share my story. And I really feel that it's my personal responsibility to carry that torch, to use my strengths and talents as an academic, to build from the foundation that was set before me. And I really wholeheartedly want to give back to those who fought for my rights that I have today so that they can live the rest of their lives with dignity and respect. And I'm learning that cultural competence is an area where I'm thinking about moving into as a way to translate and apply research to practice. So the final question was, how do we ensure that our research has impact? And I think this is a really powerful question that I've been trying to grapple with. And when I was thinking about answering this question, I kind of paused and asked myself, how do we measure impact in an academic culture? And is it the number of published papers that we have? Is it the quality of the journal that we publish in? I'm only a first year PhD student, and I'm already feeling the pressures of the tenure clock and publisher parish coming down on me. And it's hard for me because I don't want to, but I tend to prioritize my writing, my publishing, and my presentations over the other, which I would argue, more impactful measures of creating a contribution to the world. So I came into the academy wanting to make real world difference, whether it's through policy advocacy, changing laws, or supporting the passing of bills such as the LGBT Elders American Act, which is currently under review in Congress right now. Or maybe using my research to provide tools or resources or knowledge to political activists or trainers in the area of cultural competence. I think I have a long journey ahead of me to try to figure out how I can balance my own measures of impact with the measures that are being forced upon me from the academic culture. And I think that that's going to be something that I will struggle to reconcile throughout my tenure in the program.